Hello kids, today we will continue our previous chapter, that is chapter 3, okay? Now, take out this math site book, this one. Now, open page number 31. Now, today we are going to do addition on a number grid, okay? So this is another type of addition and subtraction. With the help of this grid, we can do addition and subtraction. So first we will do addition, then we will do subtraction. So in each row, there are how many numbers? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I have written from 1 to 100, and in each row, we have 10 numbers, okay? So, how can we use this grid while adding or subtracting? First, we will do the addition. So, if the question is 20 plus 3, when we do the addition in previous way, we can do in this way also. 303 and 2, there is nothing, that means 2, right? So, but when we use this grid, we have to do in this way. First number is 20, so where is 20? It is here. Then we have to add 3, that means this is grid and this are space, okay? So 20 plus 3, that is 20, 21, 22, 23, 1, 2, 3, that is space, we have taken space. So what is the answer? 23, 20 plus 3 equals to 23. So these lines are called grid and these numbers are called space. In every grid there are space, okay? Now if the question is 30 plus 15. So first, whatever the number is written in the top, first we have to find out that number in the grid 30. Where is 30? It is here. Now, second number is 15. So in if we make it how 15 will make 10 plus 5, right? 10 and 5 makes 15. So we have to jump in. The next line, that is 10. Why we have to take one jump? Because it is written here 10. So we have to take one jump. So from 30, if you jump, if you take one jump, you come to where? In which number you are in? 40. Then after this, what we have to do? We have to add plus 5 with this 40. Then 40 plus 5, that is 41, 42. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the answer is 45. Okay. 30 plus 15, 5, 3 plus 1, 4. We get the answer here. In addition, always remember this thing, in addition, you have to go downward. When you are using the grid, you have to go downward. But in subtraction, you have to go upward, okay? And while you are using the space, you have to go in addition, you have to go right side, and in subtraction you have to go left side. Now next, if the question is 61 plus 30, so if you write in this way, then first we have to find out 61. Whatever the number is written in the first, we have to find out that number. Where is 61? It is here. Then we have to move down. Okay. So how many steps we have to go down? 30 means 10 plus 10 plus 10. So we have to jump how many times? 3 times. From 61 we have to go down. Why? Because we are doing addition. So jump from here 1, 2, 3. That is we are in 91. So the answer is 61 plus 30 is 91. There is nothing, there is 0. 0 means we have no space. Okay, we don't have to take any space. That means 10 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10. 1, 2, 3, 3 step. Then the answer is 60 plus 30 equals to 31. Now if the question is 20, if the question is 46 plus 23. Now here first we have to write 46, then give the plus sign, then we have to write 23. Now if you are using this grid, how you will find out the answer? First number, find out the first number, that is 46. Where is 46? It is here. Here are the 46, okay? Then in the second number, which number is this? 23. That means 10 plus 10 makes 20, right? 10 plus 10 makes 20 and plus 3. That means 20 plus 3 equals to 23. So how many times we have to jump from 46 downward? We have to jump downward. So here it is 46. We have to move downward. 1, 2. That is 10, 20. So we are in 66. Then we have to take how many space? We have to go how many space? 3 space. That means 1, 2, 20, then 3 space in right side. When you are doing addition, you have to go right side. So from 66, if you take 3 space, 1, 2, 3. So the answer is 69. Okay? 46 plus 23 is 69. In this way, you can find out you can do the sums with the help of the grid. Now in subtraction, this is the method we can use in addition. Now while you are doing subtraction, in the here, what you have to do? First you have to find out the number, then you have to go upward. Okay, suppose the number is 32 minus 11. So why is 32? Here it is, 32. Then how many what is the number here? 11. 11 means 10 plus 1, right? So we have to take first one grid. We have to go to one grid. Then where is 32? Here. Then we have to go upward. In this time, we have to go upward. Why? Because we are doing subtraction. But if we are doing addition, then we have to go downward. So from 32, we have to take how many steps? One step, that is 10. 32, one step, that is 22. Okay? Then we have to take how many space? One space. In subtraction, we have to go left side. From 22, if you go left, if you take one space, then what will be the answer? 21. So the answer is 21. That means 32 minus 11 equals to 21. Okay. Now remember this thing. जब भी एडिशन करोगे ग्रिड सिस्टम में, उसमें क्या करना है? फर्स्ट नंबर जो भी होगा उसको फाइंड आउट दैट नंबर ऑन द ग्रिड. हियर इट इज रिटन 20, सो आई फाइंड आउट वेयर इज 20, इट इज हियर. देन विच नंबर इज दिस? 3. सो दिस लाइंस आर ग्रिड एंड दिस नंबर्स आर स्पेस. ओके, तो 20 से क्या होगा, क्लास करना है 3, सो फ्रॉम 20 कम हियर बिकॉज वी आर डूइंग एडिशन, सो वी विल गो डाउन. ओके, सो 1, 2, 3, वी हैव टेकन 3 स्पेस, दैट इज दैट मीन्स द आंसर इज 23. एंड ईच ग्रिड हैव 10 नंबर्स, दैट्स वाई whatever the number is written here, we can go according to that numbers. Okay, so next question is, -21, so first number is 42. So what we have to do, we have to find out 42 in this grid. Where is 42? It is here. Then how many numbers, which number we have to subtract? 21. 21 means 10 plus 10, that is 20 plus 1. So we have to jump how many times? 2 times, 10 plus 10. That means every row have 10 numbers, so that means from 21 we have to go upward. Why? Because we are doing subtraction. So from 21 if you jump 2 times, then what will happen? 1, 2, that is 10 20. So we are in 1, then we have to cut 1. So what will be the answer? From 42, right? Here is 42. Then we have to subtract 21 from 42. We have to subtract 21. First, we have to break this number 21. First, we have to break this number 21. The answer is 10 plus 10, then plus 1. That means we have to jump 2 grid. Where is 42? It is here. Go upward. 10, 20. Okay, then how many space we have to take? 1 space, that means 1. Then the answer is 21. Now question is 72 minus 10. Now where is 72? It is here. Minus 10. 10 is already written here, so we don't have to break this number. So we have to take how many jump? 1 jump. That is, if you cut 72 from 10, what will be the answer? The answer is 62. Okay, now if the question is 85 minus 30. Now first number is 85. Where is 85? It is here. Now we have to subtract how much? 30. 30 means 10 plus 10 plus 10. 0 means nothing. So we have to take 3 grids, right? And we have to go upward because we are doing subtraction. So from 85, you have to go upward like this. 10 plus 10 plus 10. So what will be the answer? 55. Okay, so in this way we will do the exercise, that is 3.6. okay, now we will do exercise 3.6. first we will do addition. Okay, so now question number 1a, what is written here? 23 plus 32. So that means we have to find out 23. Where is 23? It is here. Then what you have to do? Second number is 32. That means 10 plus 10 plus 10 plus 2. 10 plus 10, 20. 20 plus 10, 30. Plus 2, 32. Okay. So what we have to do? We have to find out the first number, that is 23. Here it is 23. Now what we have to do again? We have to move three grades downward. Okay, why? Because we are doing addition. So from 23, if you move three grade down, then where we will go, where we will stand? One grade, that is 10, 20, 30. We have moved three grades down. Now we are standing in 53. Then after this, what we have to do? We have to take two space. And where, when you are doing addition, you have to move right side, okay? So from 53, if we take two space, what will be the answer? One space, two space. Now what will be the answer? 55. So from 23 is here, we have to go downward, that is 10, 20, 30. We have to move three grid. Now we are here. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to go, we have to take two space, that is one space, two space. So the answer is 55. 23 plus 32 is 55. And here you have to write, we move three grade downwards and two space. Okay, so we have moved three grade downward, 1, 2, 3. Then we have taken two space, that is 1, 2. So the answer is 55. Okay, done. Now next question is 72 plus 8. So where is 72 in this grid? It is here. So this is 8 is below 10, right? So what, we don't need to jump in another grid. So here what you have to do, you are in 72 and you have to take how many space? If there is one number, then that means you have to you don't have to jump to another grid. You have to go, you have to take the space. Okay, so 8 is here. From 72, you are in 72, you have to take 8 space, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So what is the answer? 79. Okay, so here also you have to write, we take eight space. Take eight space. Okay. So in this way, you have to do rest of the sums, that is question number B, C, D and E. This is your homework. Now come to the next page. Question number 2. Use a number grid to subtract the following. Now we will use this grid to subtract these sums. Now in subtraction, the question 2A. Question is 60 minus 20. So where is 60? It is here. We have to subtract how many numbers? 20. That means 20 means 10 plus 10, right? So we have to, in subtraction we have to move upward. Okay, in addition we have to move downward and in subtraction we have to move upward. So we have to move how many grades upward? 2 grades upward from 60. Where is 60? It is here. So if you move from 60 and take 2 grids upward, 1, 2, then what will be the answer? 40. So 60 minus 20 is 40. So here also you have to write. We move two grades upward. In addition, we have written downward because we have we have to move downward, and in subtraction we have written upward because we have to move up. Okay. Now second question is question number D, 82 minus 23. First put the numbers in tens and ones plus minus 23. Now use the grid. First number is 88, so find out 88 in this grid. Here it is. Here is 88. Okay. Now we have to subtract how many number? 23. So 23 means 10 plus 10 plus 3, right? So we have to move two grids upward from 88. So if you move upward, 1, 2, two grid upward, you are in, now you are in which number? 68. Then from 68 you have to take 3 space left side because you are doing subtraction, so go left side. Okay, so if you go left, if you take 3 space from here, 1, 2, 3, so you are in which number? 65. That means 88 minus 23 is 65. Now here you have to write. We move two grids upward and 3 space. Okay, in this way you have to do this sums. So rest of the part is your homework. That is question number B and question number C is your homework. Okay, now we will do is it addition or subtraction. So we have already done addition, then subtraction. Now we will do the problem sums or story sums, but before that you have to find out which story sum is addition and which one is subtraction. For that you should remember these things, that in addition sums generally the question is like, what is the total number of dash dash, how many in all, or how many altogether. This type of, if in the question this type of questions are there, then that means you the question is in we have to do addition. Okay. And if the question is how many are left, how many more books or toys are etc., this type of question means that means we have to do subtraction. For example, a shopkeeper sold 47 t-shirts and 43 shirts. How many clothes did the shopkeeper sell all together? When the word all together is there, that means we have to do addition. So that means first we have to write 47, then give the addition sign, plus sign, then we have to add 43 with 47. 7 plus 3, 8, 9, 10, 0, carry 1, 4 plus 1, 5, 5 plus 4, 6, 7, 8, 9. So the answer is 90. Okay, so you have to do this in your book. Okay, then question number 2. Rashi had 45 balloons. She gave 20 to her younger brother. How many balloons were left with her? So here the word left is there in the question. That means we have to do subtraction. How many are left? That means we have to do subtraction like this, in this way. first we have 45 balloons, she have 45 balloons, then from there she gave 20 to her younger brother. So 45 minus 20, 5 minus 0 equals to 5, 4 minus 2 equals to 2. That means the answer is 25. So in this way you have to write here. And the third one is your homework. Okay, now turn the page and come to the last exercise, that is exercise 3.7. Here we have to do story sums. The first question is, a farmer had 76 sheets, he planted 59 sheets, how many sheets were left with him? So a farmer had, so you have to do in this way, a farmer had 76 sheets, he planted 59 sheets. So the question is, how many sheets were left with him? That means we have to do subtraction. So 76 minus 59 is 17. So the answer is 7. Therefore 17 sheets were left with him. Now question number 2. A shopkeeper had 90 umbrellas, he sold 35 umbrellas, how many umbrellas were left with him? Again in the question left is there, so that means again we have to do subtraction. Okay, so the question is, a shopkeeper had 90 umbrellas, you have to write in this way, a shopkeeper had equals to 90 umbrellas, he sold 35 umbrellas. In the question, after reading the question, we came to know that we have to do subtraction. So give the subtraction sign, then you have to do the subtraction, that is you have to do the minus. 90 minus 35 is 55. So the answer is, therefore 55 umbrellas were left with him. Now question number 3. A fruit seller has 24 red apples and 16 green apples. How many apples are there in all? They are in all. So we have to find out the total amount of apples. Okay, that means we have to do the addition. So first you have to write in this way. Total numbers of red apples equals to 24. Total numbers of green apples equals to 16. So we are doing addition. That's why we have given plus sign. 24 plus 16 is 40. So the answer is 40 apples are there in all. And the question number 4 is, in a basket there are 28 white flowers and 65 red flowers. How many flowers are there in the basket? So again we have to do the addition. So first write in this way, total number of white flowers equals to 28, total number of red flowers equals to 65. So and give the plus sign, then 28 plus 65 is 93. So therefore total number of flowers are there in the basket is 93. So in this way, do this this sums in your copy, pause the video and write the sums, and rest of the question, that is 5 and 6, these two is your homework. Okay.